right here. Can you listen? 'Cause I've been trying to make you notice what it would mean to me to feel like somebody. We've been on our way to nowhere, trying so hard.
What's up, America? Coming at you live. Sorry.
It's all right. So we got it.
All right, good.
I'm so tired of being invisible, but I feel it, yeah, like a fire below the surface, trying to set me free, burning inside of me, 'cause we're standing on the edge now, it's a long way down, but
before I became the school counselor here 6 years ago, I was a stay-at-home mom for, until like Violet was in the second grade at that point, and my youngest son, Beau, was just born at that time. He was 2 months old when I started here, and my youngest daughter, Courtney, was 19 months old. My salary was considerably less, I would say, than what it is right now. But I did get paid in other ways, such as being able to spend time with my children more often than I do now.
Which did you enjoy better, staying at home or working here?
Both have been huge blessings to me. I would say I enjoyed them both in much different ways. I felt very useful being at home with my children when they were very small, but also now feel useful being able to be here. And then plus, one of my children attends this school, and then the other two will eventually attend here, so I still get to be with them.
I was in the Navy for 7 years. I was stationed in Virginia Beach in Kingsland, Georgia. I was on the USS Portland.
How much did you make?
Probably more than I do now.
Do you recommend it to anybody?
I do. I had a great time. Probably should have stayed in.
We just raise cattle and we raise hay to feed them with. In the summer we grow our own hay and we just raise cattle. It's really not a career. It's more of a hobby than anything else. Just something to do with our free time.
Do you raise your kids like how you raise your animals?
No, they get to sleep in the house. You know, the animals sleep outside. I let Hallie sleep in the house. And, you know, I let her eat supper at the table, not down at the barn. So, we don't really raise our kids the way we raise our cows.
When I first graduated, I wanted to go to school to be a veterinarian. I've always loved animals, and for as long as I can remember, that's what I wanted to do. And I went to Tech and discovered that chemistry was way too hard. And I could have studied more. I could have studied a lot more than what I did. So after about a year of being in pre-vet, I changed my major and went on to something else. Then I changed it to business finally, and that's what I stuck with, and that's what I graduated with.
And so is that what led you to be a teacher?
Yeah, I kind of did. I was in the business world for a while, working those long, strenuous hours, and finally I decided after spending some time in the schools with retirement planning and things like that I wanted to get into teaching.
Right after I graduated from college, I took a job working with the Department of Human Services, which later transferred over to the Department of Children's Services. I was scheduled to work 40 hours, but when you do social work, you have lots of overtime, you're on call 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So it was not uncommon for me to have 60, 65 hours a week in. When I started, which was in 1978, my pay was $728 a month. So my goal was to be able to work long enough to make $1,000 a month. I thought I was rich when that happened. But it kept increasing.
Okay, so before I became a full-time teacher, I was an athletic trainer. I went to college at Harding University in Searcy, Arkansas. I have a Bachelor of Science in Athletic Training. That's what I had wanted to do. And then I stayed and got my Master's of Science in Education. So I kind of combined the two. But I swore I was never, ever going to teach. I didn't want to deal with that. I just wanted to deal with the sports world. I was an athlete growing up, and I always got hurt. So I kind of had a lot of experience in the injury side of things, and I really enjoyed it. So I did 1 year of just athletic training. I would contract out to these little bitty schools. In case you didn't know, there is an Earth, Texas. It's about this big, and they have a big sign that says, Welcome to Earth. And that was where my first job was. So I contracted out, covered all this stuff, and after a year of doing that, I realized this was not for me. I wanted to be in the teaching world, and so I got a teacher athletic trainer job. So it was two full-time jobs in one, which was a lot of work and a lot of long hours. I did that for 10 years until I met my now husband and moved to Tennessee, and realized that if I wanted to have family, athletic training was not the realm for me. So I, for the last 5 years, I have done just full-time teaching and have absolutely loved it here. So that's kind of been my pathway of how I've gotten to where I am today.